Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. Today I'd like to talk to you about CCSIDs and especially UTF-8. It is curious that many developers don't take the CCSID into account when programming, and it is something we use whenever we write character strings. And it is very important to know that the system will always use the default value if we don't specify it. I'm going to give you some examples of use and how RPGle now allows us to easily convert our character strings from one CCSID to another. Let's go. Well, the first thing I'm going to do is creating a table. In the table, I'm going to store information in two different languages. For making it more visual, the languages are going to be Greek and Russian. Greek has the CCSID code number 851 and Russian has a code 878. Both are different and also incompatible with each other. That is, if the fields are created just for storing characters of those CCSIDs, then I can't store Greek words in a field encoded for words in Russian. But in this case, I'm going to use UTF-8. UTF-8 is Unicode, supports all characters from all languages all in one CCSID. Therefore, we can add data in different languages. Well, let me create a table. I'm going to drop it if it exists. Okay, and now let me create it. The table is going to be UTF-8 data. And it is going to have two fields, the ID, that is going to be an integer, and it is going to be a generate always field. Start with 1, increment by 1, and no cycle. Okay. And the second field is going to be a text, a barring character field of 100 with CCSID 1208, that is UTF-8. Okay. Well, my primary key is going to be the ID, and I'm going to give a record format name that will be useful if I want to use this file, use this table in RPG. Okay, well, let me run this statement. Okay, well, as you know, this way I'm telling the database to give an automatic generated ID to every different row inserted in the table. Okay, well, let me now insert two records, one in Greek and another one in Russian. I have copied this from the Google Translator, so I don't know if it is okay or not. Well, for the first field, I have to write default because it is a generated always field. I cannot write here a number, okay? And for the second one, I'm gonna right here something in Greek. I'm copying it from other screen. Okay. All right. And let me insert another one, but now in Russian. That is this one. Okay. Great. So if you see, I want to see the content of the file. This is what I get, what I have inside. Okay. As you see in the same characters string field, we have information in different languages. Yeah. And that is because of the Unicode. Okay. Perfect. Well, but how can this be handled in RPG? Well, Since version 7.2, we can use the word CCSID to assign different CCSIDs to our character strings. Okay, let's create a new program in rpgle and I'll show you how it works. I'm going to create a small program here in VS Code. Test 118. That's going to be an sqlrpgle because I'm going to use SQL functions. Okay. Well, as always, let me write it. The first lines, as always, this is going to be a non-cycle program. Okay. The default activation group is not going to be used, and also I'm going to use for this example the color activation group. This is going to be the main procedure. Okay. And well, let me first of all define this character field one, where I'm not specifying the CCSID. Well, in this case, at runtime, the program will assign the job CCSID to the information stored in the string. That is, if we are running a program like this in an environment with a Greek CCSID, then we can store Greek strings in this field, okay? But if it is not the case, and I want that this string stores information in Greek, then we have to assign the CCSID to the string. And this is done this way. CCSID and the number of the CCSID. I don't remember if it is 813. Okay? Well, how will we do if we want to store information in UTF-8? Well, it's exactly the same. But here we have the option of using the special identifier UTF-8 this way. To CCSID asterisks UTF-8. Okay? Well, RPE can also convert strings written as constants in our code to the required CCSID as long as they are compatible. For example, we can assign our variable which does not have CCSID assigned to a word. For example, field 1 is hello, okay? And if we want to insert this word hello in UTF-8 inside field 2, I only have to do this and it will be automatically converted, okay? It's as simple as this. Finally, we can, of course, read the information stored in the table created before and save it in UTF-8 strings without problem. And then, for example, save this information in a file in the IFS using SQL. We can do it in a very easy way. We can do something like this. Let me retrieve the information stored in the file. Select text into field 2 from the file where the ID is number 1, okay? And then let me copy this field. And then I can do this is equal to field 2, okay? And let me retrieve the second ID. Oops, check the second ID. And let me concatenate it with the first this way, okay? And now we can take this field that has the two fields concatenated, okay, the two texts that are written in Greek and Russian, okay, we can them together concatenated in this field. Then I can write them into a file in the IFS. Okay, we can use SQL this way. The file is gonna be this one in my home directory, test118.txt. This is what I'm going to write, field UTF8. And I'm going to overwrite a possible file that is previously created, okay? Okay, well, so if I compile the program and run it, let me open a terminal. Okay, let me run the program. Well, and let's go again to VS Code and let me look for the file created. Let me update it. Test118. And as you see, the file has both fields that were written in different languages into the same line. Well, as you see, it is now easier than ever to use character strings that contain information in different encodings, not only when storing them into our database, but also using them in our code in a very simple way in RPGle. Well, I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.